Don't make fun of my disaster that's behind my head right now. Why does it look like that? I'm giving Bellatrix. Greetings and salutations. Hey girl, hey, what is up? Today we are gonna get all caught up together because as you can see, I have one eye done, one brow done, but there's a lot of different things I wanna test. There's different videos I wanted to film today. But for this video, the star of the show is e.l.f.'s newest releases, which is their Power Grip Primer, getting a lot of love online, and their new Brow Lift Wax Gel. I don't know what you wanna call it, but this is supposed to be the drugstore version of the Anastasia Brow Freeze. So as you can see, I've tried it out. Got a little bit of an opinion, but since we're already here testing out products and I want to kind of wear test this primer out, I thought we could do a little look. It's actually Super Bowl Sunday right now. Primarily, we're using the Rock Candy palette, which is a new release from ColourPop. These are the tones, kind of that purpley cool tone, but we're also going to have a little bit of an assist from the Gone Matte palette, and this is mainly for our brow and our transition shade because those are like go-to things in most eye looks. So I did a little test run, figured out what lash we're going to do because I didn't want to, you know, have a 5-hour long video of me just like especially on Super Bowl Sunday. We're kind of on a little bit of a timer. In a separate video, I am going to be wear testing the new Kat Von D concealer, so stay tuned for that. That probably honestly is going up beforehand, but we'll see how that unfolds. Let's finish up our eyes together, so brow freeze first and then we'll go into our base. I'll try to keep, you know, things moving and grooving for your sake and for mine. Before I get into it though, I should tell you guys I have little like marks. You'll see like a mark here, you'll see some marks on my arm. Those are cupping marks from my physical therapist. It's basically like, you know, a technique where they put like little like suction cups on you and it helps promote blood flow to that area, relieve tension, strain, stiffness. So you'll just see those things. They look kind of funny and they're all like different colors. Like this one's like more yellowy. I definitely have a stronger one here and they're all down my back as well. Of course you guys can't see those, but the ones you can definitely see are the ones on my arm. But anywho, Intimist Brow Lift. I was surprised when I opened this that it is a gel that moves a lot. Obviously it was stored on its side in its packaging, so it's not flat at all. It looks like I've used a lot. I've only used just a tiny bit for my eyebrow, and by tiny bit I will show you. So I have the regular e.l.f. brow brush, which is a spoolie and a brush on the side, but I also bought the spatula version, which is for the brow lift. Called their brow lift applicator, but the spoolie came off, like the glue just gave up. I gotta re-glue it together. It's not that big of a deal, but this is fresh out the packaging and the spoolie just, I got a bad one, so that will be off. But the other side has a spatula, which would be great for pressing and obviously spreading. So you and me together, we're gonna come in close. As you can see, we're gonna take just a little bit, and this is way too much already, just a little bit. And this is what my brow looks like untamed. The end of it is concealed for that removed microblading redness. You don't need that much. I'm gonna apply a little by little and just wipe the rest off on my palette. So now we have an almost clean spatula and we are just spreading it out. Then I'm gonna take, oh god, the spoolie end. Let's take it by itself and kind of rack it up, pull the hairs up, get that nice and coated through the brows. My brows are laminated, but when you have laminated brows, it's basically just like permed brows so that hairs move a little bit easier, but it doesn't mean they lay exactly where they need to lay all the time. So now I'm gonna brush it to the angle I would like it in, which is kind of up in the front. As you can see, I don't have hairs here naturally, and that's just like removed microblading that's red still. So I like to go up here and start angling it out in front of the pupil, and then I curve the outside edges just a little bit, but this brow like is hella active. As you can see, it's just my more dominant muscle. This side is kind of lazy, but I can flex this side. Oh god, I can't even do it right now. This side moves a lot when I talk because this muscle up here hella active, this muscle right here not, and they're not Botoxed right now, so this is just naturally how they like to play. As you can see, there's a little bit of white. I'm gonna use the spatula. Oh god, there goes the spoolie, and kind of press it down and also get any excess gel off. And now I'm gonna fill in my brows. I'm using the Makeup by Mario. This is the, what are you called? Brow Blade, Master Blade. And I think this is in light brunette. Yep, light brunette. And I like to fill this in all over and then fine tune it with other products because this is a really natural brow product. Like vertical strokes in the front and just kind of fill in that area, and then we'll draw our arch back on. Kind of laying a rough guide right now. To be honest, my thought is it's not bad. It's better for me than the brow freeze. The brow freeze actually was just really goopy and it wasn't gonna work for my brow hairs. I know it works for other people, but on my situation, you know, more of like a brow hair that's stubborn, that needs to be permed. And in between the perms, obviously you're gonna have like random hair growth that is gonna be natural and it's gonna be stubborn. Especially, you can see like I have a lot of texture in my brows. I need a lot of help and a really good gel to hold the brows at the angle I want. Like, I want this, and I want like this, and I want like this. So the brow freeze didn't do it for me, and it kind of flaked, and a lot of my brow products, brow pencils, couldn't be applied on top of it. So it's not for me, and I think mine's expired as well. I got it when it came out, and it's like nasty looking now, so it's a little too close to my face for comfort, actually. But saved it just to show you guys. Otherwise, it's just gonna go, because it looked more similar to what we're working with today with the brow freeze, and now it's kind of not. And I've only used it twice. So as you see, we filled in some of the body of the brow. It's a little harder to use this. This looks a lot better on my Refi brow gel, which is my go-to, and I get a little bit more hair definition. So that's my little gripe, because you just get less of that negative space in between your hairs. I'm using more of like an ink-based product. This is Hailey Beauty's new Redefine product. And you'll see me use it a lot more soon, but I've been testing it out. This is in taupe. It's a little ashy for me, but I kind of like it. And I'm drawing on where I want my arch to go. I'm gonna redefine it. Pun intended, or not really, because this brow is so active, like I don't want it to point at that angle, so that's not where I wanna go. Need to bring it back down to earth, carve it down this way. So more south, and then I kind of move the brows to go at the angle I want it to. So now it's like woo that way. But as you can see, I don't have any hair there, so this product's kind of great for that. It comes in two shades. This is the ashier shade, but the other one's a little dark for me, so I would kind of have to mix both. I'm just not feeling all that today. I like to just throw it on the outer corner and fill in the rest and kind of adjust the shade as needed. Hopping into a pencil from Too Faced. Yes, I do like a mixture of a lot of things. Kind of going over where I just laid that outline to give a little texture. And I'm gonna get the bottom of the brow, especially the front, so we can kind of negate that color situation we have going on. That's what I really like the Hailey Beauty product for, because it covers the redness since it's so cool in this taupe shade. Obviously, I know the other shade is probably more flattering for me, but this is kind of color correcting in a way as well without being too dark. This brow grows a lot higher just because of that active muscle, so it ends up a little thicker sometimes, and that's what we got today. I gotta kind of brush out the top a little bit, but the more I play with it, the more I feel like I'm gonna get residue from my brush, which we don't want. Honestly, I think this is as good as it's gonna get today, guys, because my brows probably need to be laminated again. The bottom's just acting really weird, and I have like a little natural gap in a way there. Oh, I'm just gonna fill it in with a pencil and move on. So we've already concealed the lid, because when I concealed this part of my brow, I concealed the lid across, so it's all prepped and it's all primed. The brow freeze does kind of stay tacky, which isn't too bad. It's not like uncomfortable when you're moving your face, but to the touch it is tacky, so it gives a little flexibility. It's definitely not crunchy in any way, so that's something good to know. Now we are gonna quickly lay down our transition shade, which is Duvet It from the Gone Matte palette. That's gonna go straight into our crease. And then we're gonna do our brow color with Teddy from the same palette, which to me is actually a really, really gorgeous, like yellowy tone beige. Our next shade is actually in this palette too, and this is the Big Hugs shade. It's like a lighter medium purple tone color, and I'm gonna put that also into my crease. Kind of just shaping my eye with this shade too. We're gonna go out towards the brow, kind of blend towards the nose. This palette seems to be really great consistency wise. This color is important to lay and take your time because it shows right here. You'll touch it up later though, promise you that. Now we're jumping into our Rock Candy palette, and we are using shade Erupt. It's a little warmer, but she is a warm tone gal, your honor. So sometimes you just need a blend to make these cools work. Purple's really flattering. Fun fact, purple is the color that I first started wearing eyeshadow in. The irony, because my sister only had purple eyeshadows. This is what I thought I was going to school looking like. I did not. I did not. High school Sam was not blending like this at 7 a.m. Please, please. She thought she was doing things, and she probably was, but it wasn't this. It wasn't this. Even I couldn't do this at 7 a.m. So I put that shade in my outer corner and took it into my crease color. It's a little messy, but it's blended as well. So we're gonna move on and you'll see where this goes. Next shade, our darkest shade, is Dynamic in the palette. So this color I'm laying from my lash line at an angle. It's kind of just the background color for our smoked out liner, but this is the angle we're going with right here. So I was just showing you guys, but I will be laying it carefully and slowly. But of course you guys get the Spark Notes version. I don't know if y'all noticed, you see this blemish right here? She's under the skin. She popped up 2 days ago when I was messing with my face, which I hate messing with my face, but my TMJ has my face real swollen right now. It's sore, the muscles are like pissed. So I was doing like a face massage. It's just a really bad TMJ flare up. So I was just like, you know, holding, doing all these like TMJ releases, and I definitely caused that, which was annoying. We'll see if our concealer can help us out there, because we've been rocking the pimple patch for a while, but it's under the skin and it's slowly just kind of just going away. I can't pop it, can't extract it. It's really close to the eye too. Fun fact, I could probably be here on my outer corner forever, but it gets better on its own as the steps continue. So we're gonna move on to concealer, onto the lid, to this kind of space our lid out, section it off, lay it down, kind of bring it onto the inner corner a little bit too. So that is roughly the vibe, making sure my inner corner isn't too chalky, getting any eye crust that tends to be highlighted there. You think you get it all, you don't. Our lid shade is also from Rock Candy. This is Chemistry. So we're gonna be using that with our Makeup by Mario Metal Manipulator. So just basically like a mixing medium. Onto a flat brush and packing it on. So one side of my brush is wet, packed it on with that. Goes on a little bit more like a cream, like a liquid. And then I flip my brush over, get a little bit more dry, pack it on and set that way. As you can see, it's a little different over here. You may ask why. Because we're adding another shade. This is gonna be our bright shade. We want this to be primarily focused here. And at the top of this arch, we're gonna add Pep Talk from the palette using the same mixing medium. It's a little bit chunkier of a shade, but it's gonna give us at least a little bit more purple tone. And we're gonna put that just on the bottom of the lid. Once again, looks a little crazy. It needs to dry before I kind of mess with it. So it looks a little chunky. It's doing its thing. We're gonna put our lashes on while that's drying and then go in with our liner. Lashes are from the Dollar Tree. This is the Ioni Wispy Crossovers. They look like this, a little flailed out. I'm applying them underneath my lashes and I'm cutting them into three pieces, like inner corner, middle, and outer, because it's just easier for me to apply that way. And I'm using my Kiss Falscara glue. And we're back. I actually was surprised at how easy that went on. This eye, the lashes always look a little bit more lifted, so I did end up curling both sides. So got a little bit more like a awake look. I like to see how they both apply first before I curl them, because sometimes it's kind of hard to replicate how much curl you have, so easier that way. I'm using the brand new Epic Smoke Liners. You've probably seen ads for this all over YouTube. I've had it for a while. I've been using the brown shade in a lot of my looks, but I also have the entire shade range. So there's like a cream, a blue, an aqua, an orange, a red. Two different browns, like a warm brown, a deep brown. This is the black. We're gonna be using the black and the brown. This is Black Smoke. I really like these for something that smokes out. I wouldn't say it's the most long wear unless you set it, because it's a very, very creamy thing. But it has the same shape as e.l.f.'s new lip liner, which is like a triangle with a rounded bottom. It's kind of cool. So this really allows you to get that angle, that application angle. So I'm just gonna hold my lashes down and put it right here. It glides so smoothly. Middle the lid out. Boom, we got liner. We're gonna smoke that out with the backside and a brush, because this is an oval. This is what Fenty has on the back of their brow pencil, but this one's really soft compared to Fenty's. Fenty's is a lot stiffer. This helps kind of smudge, and it is a very smudgy liner, basically like a cream shadow stick. I'm gonna smudge that out. You can even smudge it forward a bit, but I like a little bit more precision, so I'm gonna use this angled brush, grab a little bit of the liner and work that into my inner corner and kind of get that angle right on our outer corner. I don't want much on my inner corner, so it's more just like for a little bit of a shadow. You can see there's a bit of glitter in my lashes. I've been trying to comb them out and I can feel that it's like falling from my lid, but but it's quite hard to get it all out. I even took the comb to it to get some. It's like stuck to the, oh god, ow, that hurt. Stuck to the glue a little bit. Next up would be Mocha Match, the brown, one of my favorites. We're gonna go right on top of the liner we just laid, and we're gonna smoke that into the outer corner, up into the shadow. And then I'm gonna go back into it with whatever brush, here she is, that we use for our outer corner that still has powder on it, and just kind of set that area so that smokiness at that angle kind of sticks. And then for our lid shade, we need a little bit more precision, kind of a shader brush with an outer edge to kind of help bring a little harmony in there. The chunkiness, I can feel it all falling down, like all the fallout, all the excess. It's hard too, because I want to keep a lot of that sheen without the chunkiness, but also shape it to the eye, so a lot of it needs to be blended. Oh god, this is the wrong brush! Gotta wipe that off. Y'all see what happens when you aren't paying attention to what brush you grab? I've done it before with my face products, and let me tell you, never again. Now I'm gonna take my makeup wipe, clean up our angle a little bit. Get a little bit of a feathering of what we just wiped, because I feel like that angle was a little wrong. All right, that's a little better. Once it dries, we'll blend it out with our brow shade a little bit to kind of just soften that line. Not too much, because we still want it clean. We don't want it to look just harsh, harsh. Sharp, but not harsh. Those are our eyes, currently, at least. I need to start my face. So hopefully we get a lot of the glitter fallout off, but you know glitter never goes. Let's start our base, Power Grip Primer. So this is basically a Milk Makeup Hydro Grip dupe, people say, but this is more of a hydrating formulation. So they used to have a green minty tube primer, and I see so much, especially on Coconut Kathy's page on TikTok, where she loves that primer, but she also loves like their jelly primer, like the stickiness of it. So that's basically like a blend of these two primers together. Their jelly primer was a Hydro Grip primer dupe, but it was a limited edition collection. This is a permanent version, which I'm gonna assume is very similar. I really like that primer. We're gonna prime half of our face. I think we should prime the side that needs it a little bit more. All right, gonna go to the nose. It is tacky. It is sticky. It's giving me Elmer's. Elmer's, and if you really try to like move it around, it slides a little bit more at least. So that side of the nose, that side of the lip and chin. We're gonna bring it back up here without interfering with the eyes. And put a little bit on the forehead. See how it works on our fine lines. It is a little tacky. Like it feels a little tacky on the face, but it does say you need to let it dry or settle for 30 seconds before you apply anything. So let's apply to the side of the face first. We're gonna be using the Makeup Forever Reboot Foundation, an oldie but goodie, one of my favorites. I thought I'd bring it back today. It probably needs a little assistance with the wear time. I've done a review on it, but it's not like horrible wear time. I don't really keep anything that's horrible wear time, but it could always be better. And this is gonna be a long Super Bowl day. So I'm gonna apply it with my Hailey Beauty sponge, leaving this whole section right here empty for our concealer. This is in shade Y365, which is my go-to shade in all Makeup Forever items. It always fits me. It's magical. They also released a new foundation, which I can't wait to try. I don't have it yet, but it should be up this month. I think it released like 3 days ago, I think. I don't know, maybe it hasn't, but I know it's released in the middle of February. It might be the replacement for their HD foundation, which is a big deal. Comes in 40 shades, I know that, but Reboot was everything it should have been. Reboot was the light to medium, lightweight on the face, good for summertime, good natural finish product. Like, come on, come on. Don't make fun of my disaster that's behind my head right now. Why does it look like that? Like things are falling out of my clip, giving Bellatrix. Here we are. I think that's been 30 seconds. I don't want to apply directly to my face with the pump because I think that would be asking for disaster. So let's just work in small sections. Wow. Y'all see that adherence? So I just used the same exact amount, and maybe because the foundation's sticking differently, I needed like a half a pump to finish my neck and my forehead. I don't need too much up here, but I need enough just to even us out. I feel like we look dewier on this side. Maybe it needs a second to settle than this side, but there is a freaking hair. It's like a lash hair. Oh, we got her. We got her. Thank God it wasn't on the other side. What if it was stuck? We don't want that. Okay, so I'm applying a little bit of lip balm, and I'm gonna go do my concealer, which I said is gonna have its own wear test, so I will be right back. And we are back. our concealer's on. We have powder a little bit on. Just right here, actually, we got so many tests. So many tests, right? I wanted to do a little bit of a blush moment. This is a new Rare Beauty blush in shade Hope. I do have a picture of their new shades swatched on my hand, so I'll add them right here with their names as well. Pretty much mauve tones, in my opinion, which kind of go with our eye look. Not typically my go-to, but definitely workable. So we're gonna start, let's just start on the back of my hand, let's be honest, because I feel like this could go really bad really quick. And we work so hard on our face, we don't want it to. So Rare Beauty blush brush. It's like a kitty paw with those sparse edges. We're gonna dab it on like that. This allows it to be a little more buildable, and I can kind of shape it where I want. So that's that. I'm gonna blend it a little forward just because that's so in right now. Just a little bit forward. And then what's left of it will go on this side. I'm gonna need a little bit more, I think. But we really have it. Actually, no. Look at that. Look at that nicely focused blush. I like this cheekbone anyway. This is my favorite cheekbone. I don't know what she'd be doing half the time. But maybe it's the acne scar placement. Like, here's my acne scar and here's my acne scar. This one's just the favorite child, basically. So this side has powder and I don't want to disturb it too much, so I'm going to leave it there. This side had a lot more room to play with. Can meet the concealer how it wants to. But that's our blush. Let's do a little bit. Kind of wanted to highlight with this, but I think that's going to be too much. So this is the Venetian Rose. Yeah, they're very similar in finish. It could totally set the Rare Beauty blush, but I don't think we need that. So she is going to sit by Miss M Cosmetics Venetian Rose. Thank you for stopping by, but we do not need your service today. Let's do a little bit of highlight and a little bit of contour. So I feel like my powder's already right here, so I don't think I can. I was gonna contour with this cream. It doesn't seem like that's gonna work for us. So I'm using the Makeup by Mario Light Medium Bronzer Soft Sculpt with a brush from Beauty Bay. This is BB104. She's cute, she's small, she's angled. We're just kind of tapping, shaping, adding a little something. Oof. That forehead just came through strong, buddy. Strong. Oh no, it might have been a little too strong. Uh-oh, coming down here a little bit without trying to make it stick too strong, but the foundation hasn't been set separately. So it's a little crazy. I'm trying to be really light-handed. We also need to get this situated. No double chin. You're not coming to watch the game. More importantly, the performance. Taking some of our powder, boop, boop, boop. Kind of blending that area out. I do feel like cheeks are looking a little different here, so I'm gonna help the situation out a little bit. It's getting a little messy. I want a soft blush. Getting a little intense, buddy. Oh, I almost got close to my concealer, but I didn't. I feel like the blush hung onto my acne scar right here. Or not acne, but acne. Active acne, not even scar. And it wins this round, basically. All right, lips, buddy, lips and lower lash line. We're doing a lower lash line today. I feel like this might make us look sick. I was kind of thinking that would be kind of cool, but let's go brown, but the warm brown. Will warm brown be ugly? It's called Nude Haze. Let's see what it looks like. I don't hate it. Yeah, I don't hate it. Kind of blending it forward. Not bad. Pretty simple lower lash line. Imagine if you were layering different browns, how cool that could be. Let's do the same thing over here. It's gonna do the outer corner. So this side, the concealer isn't set, so it's kind of sticking a little differently. Like it's hugging a little bit of the shade. So take a really small amount and just put it right here. All right, little mascara. I have ColourPop's Level Up Mascara. This one has a wand that's actually nice and skinny and tapered so I can get my lashes. What lashes I really have, we're talking about basically. That's as good as it's gonna get. We're not gonna push it and we're just gonna hope that it doesn't transfer. Oh God, I really hope it doesn't transfer. I might run a little bit of powder underneath them. So my concealer has a fighting chance. Probably won't have a chance, but we gave it a shot. Lips are last. We got a little bit of powder absorbing what's left of our lip balm. Dry lip season is in full effect. We have some of the blotted lips left. See what we can come up with. We also have these really cool gold luxe glosses from ColourPop too. Ooh, we should do the brow hack thing where you use your brow pencil and you use your blush. That would be really fun. So I think we should give it a shot. I think that deserves its own video too. All right guys, we're gonna cut it and I'll be right back. Okay, we're back. The lip is on, what do you think? Details will be in the info box of course. I think, yeah. Obviously, we're using brow pencil, blush, and gloss. I want to do a video with different combinations of that, though. So, different lips from different days. I think that would be really cool just to kind of see how they apply and how those formulas work together. Kind of really test out that hack, you know, compared to just doing one. So, this is our look for today. She's ready for the game. I kind of like it, though. Right? Look at that. It's a vibe, isn't it? Dollar Tree lash and all. So, I'm gonna pop back in a little later and we're gonna talk about our prime versus not prime. That's our main goal. Let's see if the brows last as well. Get a good look at them. Usually I have more texture showing, but it's what we got today. All right, I'll see you guys at the end of thy day. Hello, we are back after halftime of the Super Bowl and we've been wearing our face for 10 hours. So I'm gonna bring you guys in close and we're gonna talk about all of our close-up cam footage. I'm actually kind of surprised to say that I kind of prefer my not prime side. Sounds a little crazy, doesn't it? I'm oily on both sides right now, so I don't think the primer particularly helped the nose. I didn't put any highlight on, so this is all hydration, natural hydration, we should say. But I didn't really powder heavily. I did a very minimum powder today. I also did different application methods with my concealer, and I definitely favor this side, so that's really distracting me. But otherwise, I don't really see much of a difference in the base. I think the base actually applied better on this side. Weird. I think it's gonna need a little bit of further testing, but the nose crevice looks less cakey here than here, so that's something. But we both have coverage still on both sides. I just don't know if this is a primer that I'd run out to get. Granted, I'm starting to believe I might not be a primer person, to be particularly honest, but I would further test this because I like the concept of the tackiness and the product sticking. But since we did apply a foundation, I would have hoped that our cheek products would not have been affected by said tackiness, but just absorbed by the foundation. I don't know how to feel. I really don't. I don't know how to feel. I think it's something worth doing because at least my nose doesn't look patchy, but I'm not in love with it. So currently, I would not be able to rate it an A for sure. My first impressions of the new Power Grip Primer is kind of like a B minus. Maybe because it went on smooth, it didn't affect blending. Like, I like how it looked like the foundation was adhering well to it, but I don't see said results yet. I think we look smooth on this side as well. So, you know, like it could have been a C average, to be honest, but a little bit went a long way. Consistency is pretty good as far as tackiness for somebody that says it's grip. I don't know, B minus, I guess. I thought I'd be shocked. But again, I don't keep foundations around that are like disastrous without primers. You know, and I'm surprised I got this oily because it is winter time. It's super cold today too, and I was very hydrated, and this is absolutely hydrating. But I like that I can't see a line of where I'm missing foundation, just a little greasy, just a little greasy. I don't think it really helped in fine lines or anything like that either. I think the pores are more visible on the side. I don't know. I'd love to hear your opinions down below. And I'm sure there's gonna be a lot of primer loving people who just are gonna run me into the ground. I understand, no offense taken. Like, I will keep testing this out because I wanted it to work too. But we know how that works, longtime viewers. If I really want something to be awesome, usually backfires on me. Moving on to the brow lift gel. It worked. It worked well. You can see that my hairs are basically in the exact same place. And I've changed my shirt multiple times today. Multiple times. I'm actually still wearing the same bralette from earlier, but this is just like a little loungewear situation. I definitely got foundation on my shirt. Love that for me. I think it worked out pretty well. The hold is there. It's still soft. Still slightly tacky, just slightly, because the brow pencils on top help that a lot. But it's not crunchy. It doesn't feel like I'm wearing a glue stick on my eyes, which is nice. Overall, quite impressed. And I didn't expect much from it. So I'm gonna give the brow lift a B plus. A B plus. Because it's not my new favorite for sure. I'm still a Refi girl currently. But for the price, She's definitely better than the brow freeze. Absolutely better than the brow freeze. The brow freeze flakes way more. This doesn't. And a little bit goes a very long way. If you get an applicator that doesn't break on you, it's worth it. It's also worth a little DIY glue situation at home, because I think for the price, the spatula, perfect size, really great for picking it up and using it to apply. So overall, between the two stars of the show, I would definitely say give her a go, but it's really hard to find her. I'll let you in on a secret on how I found her. I got her at Ulta Beauty, and I didn't check online. Well, technically I did. I checked online and it said it wasn't in stock. But then I went to my biggest Ulta. My biggest Ulta, there's two big ones, and they're kind of like far out, but they're big. And there's a whole stack of all the new e.l.f. goodies, mascara, primer, all that stuff. And none of them were supposed to be in stock. So we know online stock isn't always accurate. That was my best bet. Go to the Ulta that you think has the best stock in your area, and that will be your best bet. Or you can get it on their website, but it's gonna be sold out for a while. It's like the putty primer. It's gonna happen. So I am gonna let you guys go now, because there's a game to go watch. I hope you guys are having a lovely, lovely day whenever you do see this. And thank you guys as always for watching. I'm honored that you spend some of your day with me and that you value my opinion enough to even watch this. So I just wanted to let you know, as always, I appreciate you guys, whether you're a longtime viewer or a new viewer. If you would like to subscribe, the subscribe button will be right here. Here she is. She's free. Free 99. If you haven't subscribed yet, we'd love it if you'd like to stick around for a bit. Or you could just click one of these recent uploads, or even do both. We like options, don't we? That is it for me today, and I will see you guys in a later video.